Hi everyone. So today we'll discuss about surface roughness symbols. So in previous video we have discussed about Tomlinson surface meter and Telesurf roughness tester, and we have discussed that how this instrument generates roughness profile. So we can measure this actual roughness profile, so that we'll be able to find out different roughness parameters, maybe RA, RY, RZ and RMS. So now we'll discuss different surface roughness symbols. So prior to that, you should know why these surface roughness symbols are important. So surface roughness symbols are basically indication of that particular surface, means this particular surface, what are the requirements of this particular surface, means when operator is going to manufacture this surface, means that operator must know what is the roughness value, what is the waviness value, which manufacturing or production process need to be used. So all these characteristics are the indication. So we need to give indication, and for that we use these different symbols, so that with the help of these symbols, operator will get to know about what is the roughness value or what are the surface characteristics of this particular surface. Because see, surface characteristics can be different for this surface. If this is actually not in application, see, proper finishing need not to be required for this surface. But yes, if it is in contact with one other surface, then in that case, this surface may require special surface characteristics. So this is basically the use of these surface roughness symbols. But prior to moving toward the surface roughness symbol, we'll first discuss basic surface texture indication symbols. And surface roughness symbol is based on these basic symbols. So there are four basic symbols. First, this is the surface whose special characteristics or surface characteristics need to be represented. Then we can use two lines, inclined lines. One is short line, one is long line, in this way. So you have to always draw this surface as a thick line and these two lines as a thin lines. So these two lines are approximately 60 degrees to this horizontal surface. Okay, so this is a basic symbol and it is not used for indication or representation purpose. But yes, all these next symbols are based on this basic symbol. So we have to a little bit modify these symbols. So this is a common that we have to consider one surface, then I have to draw these two inclined lines. Okay, and here in this symbol I have to draw a horizontal line. If any surface, see, we'll consider this object. If I have a sketch of this object, 2D sketch, maybe in this way, like in industry the operators will be having. So this will be a front view if I am looking in this direction. Okay, so if I am putting this symbol here on this surface in this way, then what does it mean? It means material removal is required for this surface by machining process. Means I need to machine this surface with the help of machining process. That is the indication of this symbol. So I can place this symbol in the drawing in this way. Okay, so now we'll go ahead. On few surfaces we will find that, see, these two lines are common. I am now a little bit modifying this symbol, basic symbol. I am putting a circle here in this way. If this symbol is used in on any of these surfaces, maybe here in this way, then it does, what does it mean? Removal of material is not permitted for this surface. Means this surface need to be remain unmachined. Okay, machining is not, your removal of material is not required by any of the production process. And four last basic symbol, this is a surface. So you can consider, in order to draw this symbol, you can consider either of these symbols. means I can consider the basic symbol, and I have to draw a horizontal line to the longer arm in this way. So I can consider basic symbol, I may consider this symbol as well. So what does it mean? It represents this surface, this particular surface represents spatial surface characteristics. And it is related to the surface roughness. Spatial surface characteristics may be roughness value, production process, waviness value, lay directions. Okay, that would be the surface characteristics for this surface. Maybe specific, what is the specific surface roughness value is required, what is the lay direction and all. So now we will be discussing this symbol in detail. Okay, so we will draw the same roughness symbol. Now we will see, we will discuss roughness symbol. So this is the surface whose surface characteristics need to be represented. Okay, now we have discussed there are two inclined lines. We can draw these lines in this way. As it is a surface roughness representation, I have to add this horizontal line as well, and I have to add this horizontal line to the longer arm. So here on this horizontal line, the production process is specified, maybe milling is required for this particular surface. So there might be the different production process. So this is basically at this part, basically production process is specified. Then here RA means this is surface roughness value, arithmetic average we have discussed, arithmetic average of ordinates. This is RA and you will find some numericals here. So what it represents? It represents, this is a surface roughness criteria where the value of this RA is 6.3 and it is in micron. So RA value required for this surface is 6.3 micron. Then here some numerical is given, that numerical represents machining allowance. So what machining allowance is required? So it is 2. And then on the right side we'll be getting the lay direction. So there are different indications for lay direction. So if this notation is given, what does it mean? Lay is perpendicular to the surface. For example, if I am considering this surface, then this would be the lay directions. Okay, this is a perpendicular to surface. The second is, this type of notation can be used. This represents, if this is a surface, if you are viewing in top view, for example, this is top view, so you will consider the same object. If this is a top view, so if the lay directions are in this, are given in this way, then is this lines are considered, this lays are considered as parallel. If lines in this way, then it is considered as perpendicular. Then there is a possibility that the third notation can be used, which is M. So M represents multi-directional. For example, for this surface, if these types of pattern is there, then this can be called as multi-directional. Sometimes this notation can also be used to represent the lay direction. So C is for circular. Circular, if the circular lay patterns are there, it is indicated with C. And last is R. If it is a radial, or lay patterns are in radial form, it will be indicated with the help of this notation. So in this way, we have to identify, or the operator will identify different surface properties with the help of this symbol. This symbol will be there on the surface. So the operator will know which production process need to be used, what RA value need to be provided or need to provide to this surface, and what is the machining allowance and what is the lay direction. And one more parameter, here also one numerical value will be given. For example, this is 2.5, so it indicates sampling length. Sampling length, we have already discussed it. If I am checking the surface values for this whole length, then this is the sampling length. If I wanted to check the surface values for half of this surface, then half of this surface is, or this length is considered as sampling length. So that value is also considered here. Now we'll move toward a third part, which is symbolic representation of surface roughness on drawing. Okay, there is a possibility that multiple triangles may be used on some drawing. For example, if you have considered this rectangle as a drawing, then there is a possibility that on some cases you will find this type of symbol with roughness grade value. Specific roughness grade value will be mentioned. This symbol may be with N11. Sometimes I may use two symbols with N6. So these symbols represent surface roughness values that we have already discussed, or what these symbols indicates, and along with grade will be specified. So there are basically 12 grades, starting from N1, N2 to N12. If on specific surface, if N12 grade is mentioned, then we have to by default consider the roughness value is more than 50. Means if the roughness value for particular surface is more than 50, only grade number is enough. No symbolic representation would be there. So basically these triangles are to indicate the roughness values. When we use the complete, or when you use the complete symbol in this way, so along with the roughness value, it indicates many other parameters. But as far as we are dealing with the roughness symbols, so these types of four categories can be used over the surface: first symbol, two symbols, third and fourth symbols. So along with, if third symbols, there might be the possibility that if this is a surface or drawing, then here there is a possibility that three symbols would be used. At that time, you have to see its roughness grade. You have to look for this roughness grade. If these three symbols along with N5 roughness grade is given, then you have to see that the roughness value for this particular surface is 0.4 micron. This is a value associated with N5 grade. So for N4, N5, N6, same symbols are used. But yes, as the grade is different, roughness values requirement is different. So along with these triangles, the symbols on the surface, you have to see which grade value is used, and accordingly operator will select, or we can get an idea about that particular surface or the requirement of surface roughness for specific surface. So this was all about the surface roughness symbols. I hope you understand what is basically, for what purpose the surface roughness symbols are used, and what types of surface roughness symbols can be used. So in next video, we'll be starting for the flatness measurements.